Get it down to a nice clean white colour. It's the same sort of process if you're going to get egg whites in a bowl until they change colour or if you temper the chocolate. After this one, probably about 1 o'clock. Thank you. bit of our pale blue. We're going to wrap it in an outline of dark blue. So this will just give every berry an outline, a bit of definition.
Yep.
Okay, so now I'm just going to stretch this out to get my six berries. That's going to sit on top of our cluster of blueberries. I'll start building my little blueberry stack. So I'll join three together at the bottom. Come up to the next row, put two on. On the top, I'll put my last one. I'll grab my bits of white from the start that will just hold my blueberry pattern together for me. Okay, so I'll just bring Mel's little stem over now. I've got a couple of bits of white from the start that I'm just going to use to keep my stem nice and straight. And that's our blueberry pattern done. So the next step, we're going to wrap it in a bit of white just to centre our little picture in the middle of the candy. Okay guys, so the last step is the outside skin, so our last piece of blue, we're just going to flatten that out to a big sheet and then we'll wrap it around this cylinder that has our little blueberry picture in the middle. Okay, so the next step, we're going to start bringing this candy down in size. So we're going to take it down to a bottleneck at the front and the rear. This just makes sure we have all of the pattern of the candy coming through evenly. Thank you. now by hand down onto this bottom table, which is at room temperature. Mel will be down there. She'll take the strand of candy, chop it into sticks about a foot long, then roll the sticks of candy under the fans as it's cooling, just to help keep it nice and round. Once it does cool down enough, we'll chop a bit up and give you a closer look at our blueberry.
Like to be here.